Sometimes you just gotta get creative. When tree bark's too thick, you make your own. So I went for a bark inlay and I couldn't cut it thin enough for the deer antlers, which you'll see. Let's see if we can get that right in there. I kept cutting it. I could get it thin enough, but little pieces, and I kept getting unclean gaps. So in an effort to keep the bark theme, I had a couple of these little pine cones that we got at the park one day, and I found that if you essentially pulverize them and pack them in the groove, that it looks like bark, so we're gonna give it a try. So I was doing this and trying to crush them with my fingers. Still get these, let's see, big flakes there, which was cool for the bigger parts, but when I was using essentially powder for the smaller, it didn't work. So we're all going all fine powdery because it looks pretty awesome. So when in doubt, some power tools. Actually, I'm using a Ninja blender slash essentially a blender food processor. See how it turns out. Go get a little creative when you're doing your inlays, because you gotta, especially with long designs like this, you want to keep a flow. And like I said, when I was using little pieces, big pieces didn't flow. And the small fine pieces fit in there perfectly. So this is what I use to inlay small things. I used it for the eggshell mosaic, which is this one here. It looks good for light material. Anything heavier like stones, something like that. Gorilla glue. The super glue works wonderful. But here with lighter material, the Mod Podge will work great. Dries crystal clear. Does give it a little sheen, which is fine because these are going to be outdoor pieces and will get like a varnish urethane on them, so we don't mind that. Alright. I haven't tried this out yet, by the way, in the food processor, so could be filming this for nothing, complete fail, but with these, so if you can see, when I peel it, inside has like a fibrous, let's see, it's like a fibrous core. I've been discarding those. I mean, I'm sure they'll do just fine, but when I was busting them by hand, they were not looking too good. So here we go. Let's see if this works. There are a couple whole ones in there. Now I assume I'm gonna have to pick out bigger pieces, but this should give me what I'm looking for. I'm gonna have to discard some of the bigger stuff, but that'll work. Put it in for a little longer. So we'll see how it works. May not post this if it's unsuccessful, but I have a feeling it will, so I'll put link, or not link, I'll post the finished piece to show you guys how it worked. But yeah. Mini pine cones crushed up, smaller pieces for inlay. I'm sure if you had a bigger piece that you were doing inlay with, you could use the individual cone pieces. It's not coming in well, but I've also seen people use these for like little cottage pieces, turn gourds into cottages, using these for the roof shingles. Maybe we'll give it a try, but hope it works out and I'm able to post finished product. Thanks for watching.